There was always the weird kid at school who likes bugs, you know the one. He would play with worms or pull the wings off flies. It's like he revelled in the punishment and got great joy from making people sad. And you know what that kid is doing now? He works for the TSA. So no doubt that he also is enjoying Starship Troopers Terrain Command. Question is though, boys and girls, what about the rest of us Cockney gamers? Is this a game that we too can enjoy? Well, Reggie's going to spill the bug juice for you all in today's review. Now, like a lot of you watching, I'm a big RTS fan. Where running home from school to play the latest and greatest Command & Conquer was a moment of pure joy. And I still search for that good RTS feeling that few games really have since matched, in particular around the tension, strategy requirements and sheer mayhem that was on display in the early RTS game genres. So enter Starship Troopers then, a game released 25 years after its theatrical release, but with 2022 hardware at its disposal. So it's with a heavy heart that I've got to report that this is one huge missed opportunity that could and should have been so much more. You see, it all starts immediately with scale. Or as my wife would say, it's lacking in the size department. Back in 1997, when the movies came out, it was an impressive technical tour de force as being one of the earliest examples of having hundreds upon hundreds of CGI baddies on screen at once. In some respects, having hundreds upon hundreds of bugs is what Starship Troopers became famous for, as much as its satirical, albeit poignant points it makes about sending young kids to war. Yes, people, look it up. There is more to Starship Troopers than just bug mashing, but issue is, in a video game, that is exactly what I want. I want to mash bug after bug in their bloody thousands. Playing They Are Billions gives you a sense of scale in how many baddies we can get running on PC hardware. Or indeed, if you look at the latest Ultimate Battle Simulator 2, where they've actually achieved this in 3D. But in Starship Troopers Terrain Command, it just feels a bit feeble, people. Like the bugs that you're squashing are already thin in numbers. And only at rare moments do you actually think, oh, we better get a move on here, only for the mini wave to end and that be that. And that's just the initial impressions, people. Reggie, of course, had to keep playing to give you boys and girls more detail, and that is what he's gonna do, because in the next element, what I really struggled with and what fundamentally killed the game for me is the sheer lack of strategy. You see, they steer clear of base building in this game, more on that later, boys and girls, and instead they ask you to secure tactical areas of a map, such as securing certain cargo caches with a limited number of troops. The more you secure, the more points you get at your disposal, which usually means having the ability to purchase more units. And this in turn means you get enough units to conquer the final area of a map, which may consist of a few big bad bugs. But therein lies the problem. I don't want this to be a numbers game, people. I'm not in my 20s anymore going to nightclubs and just hitting up as many people as I can. I want to be more strategic in how I do things. I want the ability to be smart, perhaps using just one or two units to cut off the bugs from one area and preventing them from reinforcing. I want to be able to leave a few units at certain choke points to cut off their attacks whilst I go about mopping up the little critters with my remaining forces. But because the bugs are effectively holed up in these little bug caves, all you can really do is send a shitload of troops and usually overpower them with sheer numbers. Now, it's not all bad here, people. One thing I do like about this is the way in which the bug caves behave. They are littered throughout the map, and unless taken care of, you'll constantly get these little mini attacks on your main base. Now, with each cave, there are effectively lives represented by the bug icon. As you get near a cave, a shitload of critters pop out, and that's when you'll see the health bar deplete. Once depleted, the cave loses a life, and you continue the attack again until nothing is left. This is arguably the biggest challenge the game throws at you, as you may be marching across the gaff with your troops, and unless you've got enough numbers to take them all down, you're going to get outnumbered and be brown bread. Once all lives are gone, you can enter the cave to wipe out the threat to the map. It's a pretty neat setup, But the missed opportunity here comes from the way that you take these down. There isn't really a proper order to it. You just go to the nearest one, and as mentioned earlier, you just throw numbers at the problem. It's like World War One trench warfare in this game. Should you foul, it's no problem, as you just call in more troops using your resources, and they appear back at your base. And your resources, by the way, they're kind of unlimited. The only constraints you really get is how many troops you can have on screen at once, and so you never really feel at risk of losing, other than for those missions that are inside where you do have a limited number of twats at your disposal. Now, talking of strategy, let's go back to the non-existent base building element. Now, for me, this was a risky design choice and not one I was totally against if executed well. Personally, I place the buildings and defences where I like, but if you're going to take that power away from me, then you better have some bloody good and interesting units to play with. And that, again, is where this whole thing falls flat, because the variation in troop choice is pretty standard, with the usual riflemen, rocket launchers, snipers and the like. In fact, the snipers are probably the most overpowered unit of all, picking off bugs from afar. Get a group of them going together and you're laughing. However, just get a group of any variation and you're pretty much going to win through sheer numbers, other than a few types of bugs that might need slightly more firepower. For example, the big bloody tank bugs can be a pain in the ass, and they can be taken down by anyone, but rocket launcher troops will be a little bit quicker. Same for the flying bugs, anyone can take them down, but your snipers will pick them off easily. Generally speaking, the bug variation is better than the troop variation, where I have to say everyone just looks like a bloody clone. As for story, it's cheesy and cringy as fuck. Now, don't get me wrong, the film was like this too, but that was also an intentional artistic choice from the director, and they made it overtly obvious, so it was also funny. Like I say, it's making a very strong point, people, about war in general, supposedly. Anyway, here though, what we have is just utter nonsense. It's more the script that lets itself down than anything else. It's just not funny when it should be, it's not emotional when it could be, and you have no real understanding what might happen if you fail a mission. Instead, you're just simply told a bit of story where bugs have landed, and then you progress on the map to the next area where they've landed again, and then you wait and you continue for more dialogue, rinse and repeat. You really get the idea here. And that, my friends, is really how the game plays. It doesn't feel like a free-flowing RTS game where you start with nothing and end with an army to take down the big bad base at the end of it. In Starship Troopers, you are basically just clicking non-stop on the map in a very reactive way, waiting to be attacked and then move on once it's all cleared off. It's an utter bore fest. Now, graphically, things do start to look up. The game runs very smooth and the bugs look great, in particular when they start climbing the walls of your base. The colour palette is spot on, and I have to say the overall look and feel is Starship Troopers through and through, so the artists and animators here have done a very good job on this part. But wait up, what the fuck is this? You see, I mentioned the troops look pretty much the same, but the worst part is actually the animations. We've just spoke about how good the bloody bugs look, but the troops, they are an absolute travesty, people. When they shoot, they flip their guns up and down like they've all got some kind of Tommy Tank RSI injury. And the worst offender is the sniper, who is constantly teabagging the floor each time he shoots. It looks bloody ridiculous. And when I think back to the film, I just wish the guns looked and felt more meaty versus this kind of tracer style bullets that you see here. More so, you can't walk and shoot at the same bloody time, which for me is a big no-no, considering the movie was all about that last scramble to a plane, that desperate attempt at shooting the bugs to avoid death. Everything here, it just feels, it just feels calm, it feels safe. I want to see the desperation, and this could have easily have come out in how the troops behave with their animations. As for ground textures, they're solid. Lighting is decent. There aren't many other particle effects going on, such as rocks or buildings crumbling from the insane gunfire, so it never really feels like a war zone down here. Likewise, there's plenty of cover to hide behind in this game, but for whatever reason, they didn't go with this mechanic, which is odd, considering the animators and designers have put so much effort in creating it for the environment. The sound itself is okay at best. I've already mentioned the god-awful voice acting, and the sound effects aren't that much better either, if I'm honest. I would have loved to have had more voices from the troops you play, so have them screaming out in fear, in pain, or rallying themselves up for a big fight ahead. The bugs, however, do sound satisfying when they hit the bucket, and the actual music itself does a trick, bringing the movie franchise to life. The one area that really lacks for me is when the big bugs die, you know, those big bastard ones. In my head, I was expecting the sound to be insane like you get in the movies. Not here though, they fall down in a bloody whimper. When a wave starts on the map, you do get a nice little tempo increase in the music, and that does help raise the tension, were it not let down for the lack of numbers attacking you. Overall then, a pretty mixed bag, people. You'll get some enjoyment from this if you are into your RTS, but likewise, know this, it's very much a casual type game with very few challenges to contend with. The visuals are on the most part very good, and the sound is, well, I guess sound, but fundamentally, at its core, Starship Trooper Terrain Command is just bland and boring. You don't feel the tension from the movies. You don't get to experience the epic battles where you feel insignificant to the vast bug numbers that are heading your way. And you certainly don't feel like replaying the missions in the scenario mode. Looking back, perhaps they should have focused more on the base building aspects, where you would have had to have mined and farmed materials, because it could have offered so much more in the strategic approach versus what it is in the current form, which is a point and click troop moving game with very little substance underneath. Until next time, people, speak to you all soon. Reggie out.